It's the 2K Sports Pregame Show, sponsored by Kia.
This is the NBA on 2K Sports. Ernie Johnson, happy to be here with my friends, and I mean that, my buddies, my pals, Kenny the Jet Smith and Shaquille O'Neal. Tonight, it'll be the Philadelphia 76ers going up against the Minnesota Timberwolves. Well, for Minnesota, this is their first time facing off this season. Last year, they split the season series at a game apiece. You look at Andrew Wiggins, number one overall pick in 2014. You can see he's just oozing talent. But what is his ceiling, ultimately?
Reminds me of myself.
Have an interconference affair lined up for you today as the Philadelphia 76ers come in for this one, bringing you another edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Greg Anthony. And before we get underway here, let's send it.
Guys, you told me their primary.
Thanks so much, David. Off goes to Minnesota. Now a chance, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. The starting five on the floor. And so, in the game for the 76ers, a prodigy, he's in a shooting guard. Sarge is out there with Simmons. Then there is Jahlil Okafor, and it's Mills in at the one spot. Philadelphia moving the ball around. And Simmons kicks to Mills, and that one, good.
Boy, the feed inside has got to be perfectly placed. It nets him 2 points. That's nicely done.
And the call will go against the prodigy.
I'm Fred.
That's his first foul.
Ref's calling it close already as he picks up a quick early foul.
Levine laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
That just makes his way inside. Levine has a score first mentality.
Pass to Simmons. Dishes it to Okafor. He kicks it to Simmons. Here's the prodigy. A three-pointer off the mark. On defense, Philadelphia. They defeated Indiana in their last game.
And they ran their offense nearly to perfection in that one. Very few possessions were wasted.
That's what you call precise execution. And to do it in front of a loud, hostile crowd, they had to have excellent focus and discipline. That was really well done.
Wiggins passes to Dunn. Let's go. And he didn't get quite enough under that one.
Ill-advised shot there.
You know, I really expected him to swing that one back around.
There's a chance he could go for a big game if they don't beat him up on the perimeter.
Towns, the screen. Outside, Levine. Inside. Here's Dunn. He hits it from nine. Dunn's got his second basket of the game.
You know, outstanding start. You've made three of your first four.
And Simmons kicks to Sarge. He feeds it to Simmons, to the middle. No good from the prodigy.
That is some tough defense there against one of the better finishers in our game.
There's Levine. So he gets the whistle, contact on the way up, and two shots coming up.
You know, I like that mentality by Levine, taking it inside, mixing it up a little bit.
The Timberwolves shooting their first free throws of the game right now. And so Levine nails both of them. First quarter of ball, almost 2.5 minutes in. Sarge passes to the prodigy. Towns against Okafor. Battles through traffic and lays it in. For Minnesota, they've gone 3 of 4 from the field to start out the game. Dunn dishes to Levine. Towns the screen. Ball's knocked loose. Fast break, Philadelphia. Here's Simmons. It's hauled in by Dunn. Minnesota in the lead. First quarter of play. We're about 3 minutes in. Outside, Levine. Let's the three fly. Nailed from three-point land. Levine's got seven.
Well, spacing the floor. With Levine hitting from range, the offense benefits greatly.
Jacks up a three. Another three for Philadelphia. And you can see it in Prez's eyes. There is no way he's missing that three.
And when he wants to hit from deep, it's almost as if he wills it in if you let him.
Millsap a screen, fires the three. Levine can't hit.
Oh, that's a great look at the basket. Sometimes you feel like the shot is good, and it just comes up that much short.
Okafor gets the bucket.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agenda.
Dunn kicks to Levine. Towns the screen. Levine wide open. Loses the defender with the screen and drills the jumper.
Come on, gentlemen. Let's go. We have got to toughen up our defense on Towns. He's getting into our paint at will.
Big group substitution now for Minnesota. Cole Aldrich, he's checked in for Towns. Hill comes in for Paul Millsap. Jones checked in for Zach LaVine. And Ricky Rubio subbed in for Dunn. And the 76ers will go for a different look here. Joel Embiid, he's checked in for Okafor. Noel comes in for Saric. Robert Covington's checked in for Simmons. And Jared Bayless subbed in for Patty Mills. And you can count it. He'll go to the line with a chance to make it three. It's going to be Embiid shooting. It's going to go on Cole Aldrich. Philadelphia shooting their first free throw of the night. The free throw drops for Embiid. Looking at the last game for the Minnesota Timberwolves, it was a loss to the Spurs in San Antonio.
And the issues they had defensively, in part, I thought, was a huge factor. Really compounded, I think, because it was a road game for them.
Listen, the offense had the crowd's energy to feed off, but it doesn't explain a lack of effort on defense.
The Timberwolves shooting their third and fourth free throw attempts of the game.
Two shots.
And they can't make the second free throw either, missing both. Here is Bayless. 17 seconds left to play in the first quarter. To the inside. And it's stolen by Ricky Rubio. It's blocked. And that's out of bounds. Minnesota will retain possession. Seven seconds left in the first quarter. 3 seconds left. And it's good on the way in. Rubio's got his first points of the night.
Well, that's the way it works. Good call, good finish inside by Rubio.
Tie game and some big points being... Well, it's been a tight one so far as we get the second. Another look on the floor for Minnesota. And the 76ers with some changes. The 76ers leading. So on the floor for Philadelphia. A prodigy in a two-guard. Saric is out there with Okafor. And it's Mills. And it's Simmons in at the small forward position. Six to shoot. For three. Paul Millsap with the rebound. Minnesota's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. It's a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Hi, Kevin. Well, the prodigy in the last time out against the Pacers was terrific. He scored 18 points and was effective from long range as well, with a number of threes. A great game from him and a very solid start to the year for his team. Kevin?
Thank you, David. He had a heck of an outing that night, GA.
Yeah, he really did, Kevin. I mean, a very professional performance. Played hard every single second he was on the court.
What I like, he was in total control. Gave them a number of things that they needed to compete, and it was overall an outstanding effort.
And I like the fact that the defense is looking to protect the rim at all costs.
So good at drawing fouls as well as making foul shots. This is a big part of Petkovic's offense. Among the league's big men, he stands out for his free throw shooting. He's always steady there.
Saric passes to the Prodigy. Out of bounds, Minnesota takes possession. A chance here to assess what parts of the floor the attempts have been coming from as we look at the shot chart for Minnesota.
And the one thing that jumps out at me when you look at that shot chart is just how little scoring they get from out above the free throw line extended three-point range. They've got to get more points from out high if they want to improve their offense.
To the middle, Okafor with the steal. And now in transition is Mills. Here we go. Yep, that one goes. Mills has got 7 points.
And the lead goes right back. What a seesaw affair we've got going on.
I'll tell you, what a battle. Neither team giving an inch. The lead changing hands back and forth.
And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. That one on Saric.
Well, that's a plus to Towns' game, right? He was a great free throw shooter in college, and that's carried over.
And Towns drops them both.
Well, he's just got terrific touch at the line. We've seen that over and over again.
Philadelphia moving the ball around. Here's the Prodigy. No good on the triple.
You know, after draining a three-pointer in the first, he's been unable to capitalize since.
Here's Dunn. He's coming off a 10-point game against the Spurs in San Antonio.
You also have to credit his passing. He constantly found his teammates wide open, carving up the defense. You know, the key to that possession was really the pass. Perfectly placed assist, made the shot the easy part.
The shot's good from the Prodigy. A large part of All-Star Weekend is having the best of the best all gathered in one city. Prez will be among those in attendance as the festivities get underway.
And what a great feeling it has to be for Prez and everyone else to just get to relax and enjoy the game of basketball. All-Star Weekend is completely for the fans, and all these great players are still fans of the game.
Dunn shot's good.
And how about Dunn getting the ball in a great spot, making the deep attempt look too easy?
There's 21 seconds left in the first half of the game. And a foul on the shot. He'll go
Come
to the stripe
now.
For two. That's on Ben
boys.
Simmons.
No wasted trips at all. They're taking care of business at the line.
The Timberwolves shot 9 of 11 at the free throw line. The first free throw is good.
And Dunn does a little bit of everything out there. Scores the ball, distributes it well, and also pounds the glass aggressively.
Pass to the Prodigy. The feed to Noel. Up again. It's good on the putback.
And, folks, he did not luck into that one. He knew just where he wanted to be to grab that backboard.
And a pretty tightly contested game here as we end the first half. We come back to Minnesota now with a striking look at the 10th Avenue Bridge, downtown Minneapolis, off in the distance. And it's been a back-and-forth game so far with no ground given through the first half. Third quarter starting here now. You look at Zach LaVine, he's really been playing well.
And the thing I noticed most in that first half was his offense. He was not wasteful with his opportunities and also did a great job of converting with the chances he had.
Yeah, for the most part, he took only good shots. And given his success, they may want him to be a bit more aggressive in the second half.
A high-flying pair of LaVine and Wiggins are the two and the three. Towns is out there with Paul Millsap, and it's Dunn in at the point guard position. So that's the lineup for Minnesota. And so it looks like the Timberwolves will retain possession here. And there before you are the teams that have been absolutely red hot for the last 10 games. The 76ers, number one.
Boy, they've been hot. You love to see this kind of offensive execution.
Now here's LaVine. He's covered closely. 5 to shoot. Dunn misses. Philadelphia's gone 4 of 8 tonight from three-point land, shooting 50% on the three ball here. The pass to Simmons. Inside. From down low. Again, Philadelphia. Timberwolves trail by three. Done with it. He's got eight. It's tipped.
And don't forget about the long reach that Simmons possesses, that he uses it exceptionally well on defense to come away with blocks like that.
Tyus Jones, he's checked in for Dunn. And Philadelphia also making a switch. Robert Covington's checked in for Simmons. For three, Levine. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound.
And out of the gates here in this second half, they have not started well. 0 of 3.
No good from the Prodigy.
He's been off and on tonight, and that one didn't fall for him, but they still hold the advantage in this one.
Fires from deep, and it's Levine that time on the assist by Jones. Levine's got the game tied up here for Minnesota. Philadelphia's gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Now Mills. He's got 10. To the paint. Here's the Prodigy, guarded by Levine, and he gets it again. Shot good from the Prodigy.
They are just killing him on the interior.
And the call will go against the Prodigy. That's foul number two for him. Minnesota making a switch. Bekovic has checked in, and the 76ers also making a change. Bayless has checked in. Just under 2.5 minutes into the third quarter now. Bekovic dishes to Levine. Jones kicks to Towns. Unable to get that one. Now the 76ers take it the other way. So it's off to Brooklyn after this game as they have the next to look forward to. That'll be the third game of this three-game road trip. Jones kicks to Levine. 3 minutes gone now in the third quarter. Six on the shot clock. And Towns gets it to go.
I'll tell you, that's good defense. Just better offense. And not many people can match up with Karl Anthony Towns.
Here's Bayless. Stolen by Levine. Last break, Minnesota. Levine with the ball. And that misses. That would have put him up. The 76ers have gone 3 of 5 to start the second half, developing a nice rhythm out there. Good ball movement here by the 76ers. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here. The 76ers shooting their second and third shots at the line right here. No good on the free throw. Minnesota making some changes. Cole Aldrich, he's checked in for Nikola Pekovic. Here's the Prodigy. So on the floor for Philadelphia, the lengthy duo of Noel and Embiid down low. Mills out there with the Prodigy. And it's Simmons in at the three, the small forward. And it's out of bounds. They say it was last touched by Towns.
And you know what? Just a little too much heat on that pass for him to come up with the steal.
You know, I think in his mind he was already going in the other direction, but you have to make the play first.
Pass to the Prodigy. Back to Mills. Embiid. The second chance points on the tip in. Embiid's got the first points up on the board here in the fourth for the 76ers.
He fought hard for that tip in. He doesn't take anything for granted. He's going to crash the boards on every single shot.
I mean, I like the call. I thought the defense was just there a little late.
Now here's Levine. And here is Dunn, poked loose, and stolen by Simmons. Here's the Prodigy. The dive for the ball. And out of bounds as the Timberwolves gain possession. Some changes for Philadelphia. Okafor comes in for Joel Embiid, and Sarge is subbed in for Nerlens Noel. Timberwolves trail. Fourth quarter of basketball. We're about a minute into it. Towns, the screen. They He set the screen. Six to shoot. Hill passes to Dunn. And no good. Had a chance to take the lead. High post try. Shots good by Mills. Now it's a 4-point 76ers lead.
No doubt about the consistency when it comes to scoring the basketball for him tonight. A real nice lift for their offense.
Hill. And they're going to count the bucket and send him to the line. It could be a 3-point play.
And guys, all about hard work from this point on. They've worked hard to create that high quality shot and then able to knock it down.
One shot.
The 76ers have gone 2-of-4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. The Prodigy passes to Simmons. Picked by Okafor, feeds to Saric. He dishes it to Mills. Uncovered, again Philadelphia. Timberwolves trail by 3. And we're about 2 minutes into the fourth quarter now. LaVine can't hit.
And this is the thing. They're trying to battle back, but his erratic shooting is really hurting.
Mills can't hit. The Timberwolves have gone 1-of-4 since the end of the third quarter. In the corner, it's LaVine. Bangs home the trifecta. LaVine's got it all tied up now for the Timberwolves.
The ability of LaVine, it's eye-popping on certain nights.
Simmons passes to the Prodigy. Kicks it to Okafor. To the paint. Lays it up and in off the pretty assist. And the 76ers lead by 2.
That's a brain freeze right there from the entire defense. Now is not the time to lose your focus.
You know he's always looking to attack. And late in a close ball game, when he catches the defense napping, he's going straight to the rack. How about the calm demeanor of Towns, well made for pressure situations?
Here's Simmons, and then Simmons slams it in.
And that is a punch to the jaw. This game, as tight as it can be, and he pulls something off that we might not even see in the All-Star game.
Ooh, well, I don't think he planned it too far in advance. That was one of those things, you know, Greg, that just happens. And the replay, of course, presented by Kia. What a play. Wiggins is checked in for the Timberwolves. Let's go now to the sideline and catch up with David Aldridge.
Thanks, guys. I listened to Tom Thibodeau talking to his team during the break. He said, this is what we play for, fellas. Let's knock them on their heels right out of the timeout. Show them how much you want it. Go get it. He really is fired up about this game, guys.
On the catch and shoot, just so relaxed. Almost looks like Towns is playing a game of force out there.
The dish to Saric. To Simmons, trying to find Mills, gets it to him. Yes, that goes in.
Big time basket there on the inside. I mean, he had to get that one up and over the big guy.
Has the ability to score against size, and those were crucial.
Here's Wiggins, and again it's Minnesota converting.
A confident young man. Wiggins just answers the bell.
Philadelphia has gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Here's the Prodigy, cranes the three-pointer.
And those are the types of shots down the stretch that win you ball game.
Timberwolves trail by 3. Dunn kicks to Wiggins from 12 feet out. And again, it's Minnesota.
One of the reasons the scouts love Wiggins, he always finds a way to deliver in big-time moments.
Over to the wing. Here's the Prodigy. And the 3 off target. For Minnesota, they've gotten into a pretty good groove, going 6-10 here in the final quarter. And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Millsap. Here's Simmons. dishes it to Mills. The baseline J. Nails it!
Boy, what a pressure bucket that was.
But he didn't let the pressure affect him one bit. What nerves.
Minnesota calls timeout. They trail by three. 43 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Here's LaVine. But they get it back. Done. Here's Towns. Money! And what a sensational bucket to bring them within one.
When your stars shine bright in the toughest moments, Towns the look of a superstar.
And Mills kicks to Simmons. Fires for three. Wiggins with the rebound.
Hey, the defense is content to let him prove he can make that shot. And so far, he cannot.
Outside, LaVine. Got a piece of it. And they foul intentionally. They're going to have to do that now again and again.
Like
they're not in the penalty yet.
Honestly, just doing what they have to in order to get the basketball back.
We've got 13 seconds left in the game. And an intentional foul right there. First free throw is good, and that will put them up by two.
And the athleticism that Simmons has is downright unreal. Just a remarkable talent who has the potential to be one of the all-time greats.
Here's Wiggins. Oh, off target.
Wow, wow, he got whacked on that one. Shouldn't be much debate there.
So the first one drops, and that narrows the gap to one. And both free throws good for Wiggins.
How fantastic was that? One mistake and the game's over, but he gets it done.
And the 76ers call time here. Tor is tied at 60. 3 seconds play in the final quarter. Fires top of the key. Yes!
You know, the inbound play paying off immediately. They knew exactly how they wanted to attack.
Here's Towns. Oh, he had a chance there to send it to overtime, but they come up empty-handed.
The 2K Sports Postgame Show.
Thank you, Kevin. Now we move on to our Jordan player of the game, the Prodigy. Kenny, what did you like about his game?
You can have the best talent, but success ultimately comes down to who is playing the best basketball. Tonight, he was poised. I mean, he did the job. He was in control. He read the defense. I love this guy's game.
Well, what got me the most was his three-point shooting. You know, he's always finding ways to get open, especially on the perimeter. And listen, when he gets those shots, he's definitely going to hit them. That was the key. His shooting made things much easier for them offensively.
And that'll do it for this edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. For Kenny Smith, for Shaquille O'Neal, for Kevin Harlan, and for the entire 2K Sports crew, this is Ernie Johnson. I hope you have a wonderful, even beyond wonderful, a spectacular, just great. I mean, see you.
Good night.